Another message coming through, Sarah.
Oh, that's my private collection, sorry.
As soon as you left the room, I went into your case. Welcome, welcome.
Bring it in, big fella.
If you'd like to go, you're talking big numbers on Radio 2.
I know, I try not to picture. I think I pictured it once and I sort of trailed off and then just pressed like Culture Club or whatever I was playing next. So, the people, so many people listening.
Right, so let's start cruising through your videos. And first up, it's what we call the current section. So this is something you've played on your radio show recently, isn't it? Talk us through it as if we're on air at the moment and you're about to cue it up.
This is a clip that my husband sent me. A couple of people are out for a ramble, walk on a Sunday to walk off those roast potatoes, and they've got their phone out like everybody does, and they spot in the distance a donkey. And this donkey is behind a lovely sort of old sort of dry, bit of dry stone wall in, and there's a bit of wire fence in and that, and the donkey's in the field. And so they're like, oh, let's just film this donkey, this is cute. And as they approach the donkey, she basically lets loose with this beautiful bit of singing. Little Harriet. And it worked well on the radio.
Yeah, what sort of response did you,
get? You can hear the little, like the little donkey bit in between, and people absolutely loved Harriet the donkey.
Do you find that what you've been watching influences the content of your shows?
I make little notes in my phone, because if you're on the radio every day, you're sort of walking through life praying that something hilarious will happen to you, you know what I mean? So you're always after material, so it is really helpful if I do get something funny from YouTube, I will be able to then use it on the show that night.
Right, so we're on to the rewind section. This is an opportunity for you to show us a video from your career that you'd like to revisit.
There's loads that I don't want to revisit.
Well, you've done so much. So what are you picking that you'd like to revisit today?
I think a really well-loved show that I did a couple of years ago is The Great Pottery Throwdown, which people were like, God, we never thought it'd work. On paper, it sounds ridiculous. You've got a pottery competition. But as soon as I got the email about it, I knew it was going to work, and it did look gorgeous. It was a great show.
They've got to really look at Sylvain's shape. Right up close, measuring height, width, checking where the chest definition is, and translating the proportions to the cylinder.
His body's quite symmetrical, so measuring with a tool from the pecs down, working on the chest.
You know you are supposed to be modelling it on Sylvain, not yourself, you know?
Wow, mirror image.
How are you approaching it?
Well, I thought I would have a hands-on approach.
On Sylvain or on the clay?
I prefer the clay, really.
Okay. Yeah,
there might be a few who'd prefer to have a hands-on approach on Sylvain.
Clover.
Yes.
No, come on. Oh, it's such a lovely show. It looked like we went to the wrong video, didn't it, for a moment? Oh, that's my private collection. Sorry, turn that off. It was such a lovely, warm show to do, and people really, really loved it.
So we did a bit of research, and after Series 2 of Throwdown, searches for pottery went up by 66%. On YouTube. So have you ever learned anything from a YouTube video?
This is really tragic, but before coming here today, I folded up some trousers that I learned how to do that on YouTube just recently. Oh, excellent. These are my actual trousers. Where do you get these from,
Sam? I did go, well, as soon as you left the room, I went into your case.
Yeah, classic. Standard cane. Okay, so.
Let's see this.
You're off for a little jaunt, you're off on holiday, but you want to take a few pairs of trousers, but how will you fit them all in? Do this right now. Here you go. So you get your trousers and then you do that. And you're like, what? So then you fold it, you roll it very tightly like that. And then you keep going.
It's right.
It's nerve-wracking to demonstrate things. Here we go. So then you do that.
What do you do with that bit?
And then?
No.
And then, yes, ladies and gentlemen, yes. And then you pull this. This is the joy.
My life has just changed.
Right.
Holy.
Look at that. That is a pair of jeans. Woo! I'm so really, can you hear the relief in my voice?
Amazing.
That's pretty mega, isn't it?
Absolutely amazing.
Power of YouTube.
It's changed my life. That's it.
Oh, sorry.
Next up is the inspiration section, where you get to share something from YouTube that has inspired and influenced you and your work. What have you chosen?
I've got to be honest that Scott Mills is a close personal friend of mine. Yeah. Radio 1 DJ, and he's always really innovative, and the features on his radio that have now moved onto YouTube, onto the Radio 1 YouTube channel, are just fantastic. Mm-hmm. Real appointment listening, or indeed appointment watching, because he directs everybody to YouTube when he's about to play Innuendo Bingo.
Let's have a look at that.
This is Innuendo Bingo.
We're streaming live now on the Radio 1 website. Watch it on your computer, watch it on your laptop, watch it on your mobile phone. So, what happens here is we play a selection of clips of things that happened on the TV or radio that sound a bit rude. Then you both put water inside your mouths. I don't want either of you to hold back, and hopefully if you find the clip funny, the water will spray everywhere. Over to Greg Wallace now on last night's MasterChef. Really getting to know his contestants here.
I really like your fresh, crunchy, sweet coleslaw. I really like the flavour of the inside of your pie.
This is already brilliant.
I really like the flavour of the inside of your pie.
Thank you, Greg.
Amazing.
Yeah. Radio's been through so many different changes. Like when I was on The Breakfast Show on Radio 1, we used to do a feature where people would fax in drawings. It was like back in 1932.
Another message coming through, Sarah.
It really was. And so we've gone from that to now Scott directing, you know, yeah, getting people to log on, go to their YouTube, to radio on YouTube. And Innuendo Bingo just got a massive reach. But yep. Gerard Butler, instead of just being asked as a dry questions about his movie and what it was like working with that director and if he did his own stunts, instead he's getting to gob water at a random person and listen to rude clips.
When you're about to interview someone, do you watch all the other interviews they've done before?
Yeah, it's really helpful, yeah. I find it, when I'm not that familiar with someone, I find it quite helpful to see how they move and how they respond in interviews. And I think it was really helpful on YouTube just to dig out some footage of that.
The next video is something you'd like to recommend for us all to watch later.
It sounds a bit selfish, but lots of people who've died over the last couple of years, they were on my list, they were on my to-do list of interviews I want to do. I was on Radio 2, I was actually in for Chris Evans in the morning when David Bowie had died and the announcement came. Lots of people waking up to that, and to a Radio 2 audience, but to everybody, I mean, it was just so massive. Mm. And I think YouTube, what's really special about it is that it does keep people alive by having all that footage on there, all the interviews, all the footage from live gigs, and their pop videos. And I think that's, you know, it's rather lovely that you can get lost just watching all of, you know.
So shall we rediscover some David Bowie?
Yeah.
Put on your red shoes and dance the blues. Let's dance to the song.
I did have Bowie on The Big Breakfast years ago, and he was lovely with me because he could tell that I was nervous and a little bit overwhelmed and out of my depth with him. And when I was like a, you know, sort of 24, complete gob on a stick, like, hey, David, rock me breakfast, woo!
Do you show videos like that to your own kids to try and give them a musical education of a certain pedigree?
A little bit. Important? It's more that they'll walk past and for a moment it'll catch their eye and they'll come and sit down next to me and watch it. But it's quite nice when they do, you know, they can't quite believe that those were actual music videos.
Anyway, that's all we've got time for, I'm afraid, Sarah. Thanks for guiding us through your YouTube and for sharing some of your favourite videos with us. And also, thanks for watching. And join me next time on This Is My YouTube.
Thank you.